We began our morning in the small town of Gilman, Illinois. This is where the Canadian National's Chicago subdivision crosses the Toledo, Peoria, and Western. Here we see a CN local switching the small yard located in town. To the right is a tied-down TP&W freight train with a former Penn Central GP38 leading. We moved further south to Gibson City to see Norfolk Southern train D36 departing for Decatur. Conductor Brandon Elliott called out the signal as the train notched up out of town.
Thank you.
After departing Gibson City, we caught the train passing the Wabash searchlights at Osmond. After D-36 arrived in Decatur, we checked out the Norfolk Southern Yard before heading to the Monticello Railroad Museum. There we'd catch Wabash F7A number 1189 operating at the museum.
Thank you.
1189 was built for the Wabash in 1953 and was the last F7A built by GMD in London, Ontario. The engine served on the Wabash between Buffalo, New York and Windsor, Ontario. In 1979, the 1189 was retired by the Norfolk and Western and sent to Decatur to be scrapped. Luckily, the engine was donated to the museum, where it continues to operate today. We are now on the Union Pacific in Towanda, Illinois. Here we see a northbound intermodal led by a former Southern Pacific AC-4400. We would chase this train back towards Joliet to end our day out trackside.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching another Samlovestrains Railroad video. If you enjoyed, please leave a like, and check out my channel for more railroad content.